to the Staples Center in Los Angeles. It's game four between the Lakers and the Phoenix Suns. Kobe Bryant and the seventh-seeded Lakers leading the best of seven set 2-1 with an impressive victory on their home floor Friday night. And the Phoenix Suns looking to even things up and get back the home court advantage. Kwame Brown and Sean Marion. And the Lakers will control. And Yubi, one of the keys, of course, to the Lakers has been how well they played defensively as they alley-oop to Kobe Bryant.
I give the Lakers a lot of credit, Mike. They've stepped up. In games 2 and 3, Phoenix has only scored 92 and 93 points. That's saying a lot.
Rajah Bell, in and out, won't go. The Suns, the best offensive team in the NBA during the regular season, have really struggled shooting the ball.
Well, their shooting percentage is down from 48 to 44%, and they are getting hammered on the boards. Big thing for the Lakers, five guys averaging between 12 and 23 points.
Lamar Odom, who has been just superb, his all-around game, and he gets his first field goal.
I like the fact that he's looking early, and he has done that in games 2 and 3. He's looking to score. We know that he can do it outside facing, in the post, and in off the dribble.
And the first foul called against Kobe Bryant on the blocking foul. And there's a key for the Phoenix Suns. Sean Marion, his numbers down from the regular season. They need him to play a big game, Yubi.
Yes, his points are down, his rebounding is down, and also the shot attempts. Major thing right now, can Phoenix withstand the heat in this first quarter? They got to play even and got to get some confidence early.
Kwame Brown trying to get position on Diaw. James Jones in the starting lineup for Phoenix. No Tim Thomas, at least to start. He sprained his knee in game 3 Friday night. Kobe Bryant, aggressive move right at Rajah Bell.
Now I'm surprised, Mike, because the double team was late, and he will take his man, back him down. You can't play him one-on-one from the top of the circle.
So 6 straight points to start the game for the Lakers. Nash with his first shot, a hand in his face, and he knocks it down.
Now they need him to be the catalyst. He's got to step up. And what I'd also like to see for Phoenix, can Jones and Bell and then also Diaw step up and get some points?
Nash certainly needs help on the offensive end. He's had pretty good numbers individually as Kwame Brown posting up on Diaw. James Jones the rebound.
Yeah, they played him straight away that time. One-on-one.
Nash, beautiful. Nice move inside. And Nash looking to score early. He's had to do that a couple of times in this series because his other teammates not picking up the slack early.
Well, there's no way that Smush Parker can play him off the dribble, Mike.
Parker tied up. Welcome to the Staples Center in Los Angeles, underway for game 4 between the Lakers and the Phoenix Suns. Hello, everyone. Along with Yubi Brown, Elisa Salters, Mike Green on hand as the Phoenix Suns trying to even this series up. The LA Lakers very impressive in games 2 and 3. Kobe Bryant already with 4 quick points. Lakers scored the first 6. Now a 2-point lead. And Yubi, of course, one of the real stories of this series has been the unselfish play of Kobe Bryant. And it really made a difference in their offense.
Well, he's right up there with 7 rebounds, Mike, but the 6 assists, getting the players moving without the ball. And then we know that he's struggling with his shot. He's only shooting 40%, but his creativity has been outstanding.
He's 3 for 3 to start, looking for his offense early in this one. The Lakers have had such good ball movement where the Phoenix Suns, the best offensive team in the NBA during the regular season, have had their struggles on the offensive end.
Well, in games 2 and 3, you're scoring 92 and 93 points. Now, that's a 15 to 16 point differential from the regular season. Now, Nash is off to a good start here today. But the big test is, can Rajah Bell and then Jones and then also Diaw step up as well as the bench? Phoenix must shoot a higher percentage in this game 4.
Odom draws the foul, and he'll go to the line for 2 as Boris Diaw picks up his first. Today's starting lineups delivered by AT&T. A change for Phoenix. James Jones getting the start. Tim Thomas sprained his knee in game three Friday. He'll come off the bench. Rest of the lineup remains the same. Meanwhile, for L.A., Walton, Odom, and Brown in the front court, all with double-doubles in game three Friday night.
Well, to me, that has been the big thing here. That's the big story. Naturally, Walton and Kwame Brown are getting more minutes. Now, when more minutes come, naturally more shot attempts. But the starting unit, everyone is averaging between 12 and 23 points. Great balanced scoring.
James Jones, again, getting the start. Can't knock it down. Jones hasn't played a heck of a lot in the series. And here comes Odom. Saw him miss the two free throws, but he's done everything else well. Pass to Kwame Brown behind him.
When you give that pass, it's got to be a bounce pass. Got big guys have trouble picking up the side of the ball.
Jones blocked by Odom. He got a piece of it, but they're going to count it. A goaltend call by Kenny Maurer, and also a foul call by the official along the baseline. So a chance for a three-point play.
Now keep an eye on this now. Now there's your foul right in the chest. All right, that's going to be interesting here, right, how they come up with this.
They're going to count it.
Right.
The basket one. He clearly hit it when it was above the cylinder.
Yes, he did.
And there's the foul as well on Odom.
Yeah. The referees were right on top of that play.
So Jones, who had 24 starts during the course of the regular season, but has only played about 8 minutes, as you see there, a game, has not been a factor in this series. A very big opportunity today, Udy.
Yes. During the season, he and House came off the bench and would give you 9 points a game. Now, in losing Thomas, you have to remember now, in the three games, Thomas is averaging 17 points and 10 rebounds, and he is shooting the three at a monster level. So they're going to miss his minutes on the court.
They hope, though, he's going to play. Certainly not the amount of minutes that he's had. And a foul call. Of course, the whole key for this series through the first three games has been the tempo. The Suns like to run. They've not been able to run. The Lakers have done a great job controlling the pace.
Well, if you shoot a high percentage, Mike, or you get fouled and get to the foul line, that minimizes your open court transition game. They have done a terrific job. Plus, they are doing a sensational job on the boards. They're giving Phoenix, who are shooting a low percentage of 44%, only 5 second shot attempts.
Odom can't hit, and Jones very active early. A couple of rebounds and the 3 points. Nash finding Diaw. And Boris Diaw, who may win the most improved player of the year in the NBA this season. He's had okay numbers, but he hasn't played at his level during the regular
season.
They
need him to create, Mike. That's the missing point. You know, the 6 assists.
Offensive foul.
Good call.
How about James Jones' contribution in his first playoff start?
Well, you're looking for Jones. He's such a good athlete. You're looking for him to give you good defense, but the key is going to be they need the scoring, and then they also need him on the boards. You have got to get on the boards. That's the big difference in this series. The Lakers are out-rebounding Phoenix 11 a game.
Nash shooting early. Knocks it down. 4 for 4 is Steve Nash. And the Suns on a 10-0 run.
Well, the leader. He's the leader, and he is playing big. And you love the fact that he came out looking for his shot first.
He's had to be more aggressive looking for a shot with the injuries and some of the subpar performances of his teammates as Kwame Brown goes long.
Yeah, when Kwame sees the switch, he should go right into the post. Stop it already. And then when you got the size, punish them.
Nash misses. Lakers looking to push early, but the Suns get back. A quick pace early in this one. Odom, nice feed. Boy, the unselfish ball movement for the Lakers has just been superb.
Now, the Lakers have three great passes out there. You know Kobe can do it, and then Odom. They're 1 and 2 in your assists during the season. But the big thing is you added Walton. So you have another creator and a guy who can make it happen for you when your people are running without the ball.
Good defense from the Lakers. They force a jump ball. The Phoenix right now with a 4-point lead. Tied up. Bench out there early as Eddie House has come on as well for Phoenix. DL alley-oop for Marion. Nearly tipped it in, but they're going to call a foul on Odom. And Sean Marion will shoot two.
Now that's a break.
Two on Odom.
Now we said early with Diaw. See, Diaw's got to be the creator out here right now. He's taking Nash's spot. Now you can see right there, that was an easy call for Bennett Salvador to make. Now, when you say Diaw must be the creator, absolutely. During the season, we know Nash had 10 assists a game. DL had 6. He steps up, he makes things happen, and especially now with House and Barbosa in there. That will allow both of these guys to move into their spot-up shooting places.
Well, Marion hits the first. Sean Marion in his 7th year in the league. He's a 3-time All-Star. This year he led the team in scoring, in rebounding, in block shots, in steals, in minutes. He had a spectacular regular season and is just trying to get it going here in this series.
Well, we said he's a 2010 guy, only 4 in the league. Right now he's 17-8 in this series. So you know he needs to step up. His shooting percentage has also got to get up there.
Lakers now without Kobe Bryant and Lamar Odom, both with 2 fouls, both on the bench. Vujicic, Bryant, Cook, and Cook knocks it down.
Now we talk about the starting unit, but 2 guys off the bench, Vujicic and Cook, are both giving the Lakers 7 points a game in limited minutes.
Cook had 9 points in 11 minutes the other night, also had 7 rebounds. Marion operating against Walton. Barbosa picks up the errant pass. Vujicic, 6 of 8 from downtown in the series. He also only has 1 turnover. He's played very well in those limited minutes. And Smush Parker, one of the real stories for the Lakers, sets for 3. Won't go. Parker, undrafted, who started all 82 games. Barbosa ahead. And that's the type of basketball you have not seen much from the Suns in this series.
During the season, Mike, the guy shoots a nice percentage. He gives you 13 points a game. Now, he has not been able to get out into the open floor much in games 2 and 3. That was good to see.
Barbosa kind of pulls the chair out from under Parker. Parker slow getting up. Barbosa inside, trying to draw the foul, and he does. So Leandro Barbosa will shoot 2.
From baseline to baseline, definitely one of the 3 or 4 quickest guys that we have in the league. And by Dial taking over, you're allowing him to run the floor. Now this is where he just explodes. He has a great quickness and then the ability to get fouled or the ability to score. He's going to get into your face because he's attacking the rim.
Barbosa just 23 years old. He's in his 3rd year from Brazil. Said it was always a dream of his to come and play in the NBA. And this year he's been such a spark off the bench for this team. You see in game 2, didn't hit a field goal. Had a couple in game 3. But they need his spark off the bench. The bench was one of the best in the NBA during the regular season, but been very quiet in this playoff.
Well, it always comes down to opportunities, Mike. Plus the fact that the Lakers have shot such a good percentage. That's keeping them out of the open floor in transition. Plus their inability to turn the Lakers over. The Lakers have been doing an excellent job taking care of the ball.
And the Suns, meanwhile, continue to hit free throws at a record-setting pace here in this series. Cook again. And Cook able to knock it in.
Well, you know he's not going to take more than 1 or 2 dribbles, so you got to get up, close him down.
House, nice drive, won't go. Knocked out of bounds, go the other way.
I like the attitude. I like the Suns' attitude with this group without Nash. They are attacking the basket. As long as you're attacking the basket, you'll get the high percentage shot, and that will tell over a long period of time for you.
Parker will walk it up. Shot clock and game clock, about a 3-second difference as we wind down the first period. Boy, this crowd has been so into it both Friday night and so far here this afternoon. George for 3. Tim Thomas the rebound. They've got plenty of time.
Plenty of time.
Thomas pulls up for the jumper. And that will end the opening period.
Yeah, it's too bad. You still got a high percentage shot. Why didn't he pass the ball to the outside lane? The defender had already favored the lane, and they were going to force him to take a jump shot. Well, everyone close to the situation explains that he's definitely broadened himself. He's allowing people to get to really know him. He's stepping out. No doubt about it, he's leading, and he's very vocal about the leadership.
All his teammates have been talking about that, and the change this year is Barbosa's shot won't go. Marion tips it but can't hold on.
Now, the second quarter is the big test for Phoenix. Throughout the 3-game series so far, They've only averaged 17 points a game. Now, that's a major drop-off, you know, throughout, because they do a good job in the first quarter, but they get that low.
And Rajah Bell picks up that foul. That's going to be the first on Bell. Mike D'Antoni and Phil Jackson trying with their adjustments from game to game. And an offensive foul call. And that push-off will go against the Lakers. It's against Kobe Bryant.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. You see Rajah Bell is going to get up in his face. And then as he was making his cut, he threw his arms up and he caught Bell. Now, Bennett Salvatore was right there. Oh, bad miss.
Bryant the rebound. And Salvatore was talking to the scores table. I don't know if he called it on Kobe Bryant. Bryant would give him three fouls. That's what they have now. And another offensive foul. That will be his third for sure, as Bell does a good job. Or is it four? There's confusion over at the scores table on what the previous foul call was. That's certainly on Kobe Bryant. But the last one, Bennett Salvatore just went over and said, no, it's on Cook.
Well, when Kobe made his pass to go into the triangle and he made his cut, he and Rajah Bell had contact. That's why he thought it was his third also. Now that one right there, that was easy.
Eddie House can't connect. Odom the rebound. So they've changed it. Kobe Bryant has three fouls. The previous one was charged to Cook. So he has two.
Now this is going to put a lot of pressure on the group on the floor. Lamar Odom's got to step up here now and lead this group.
Devin George against Bell. Bell, an excellent defender. Shot clock winding down. George can't hit, but they get a new 24 courtesy of Smush Parker.
Now, we said earlier, this is where they hurt Phoenix. There's such a discrepancy in the rebounding, especially on the offensive boards and point production by the Lakers.
Cook, a contested three. And Barbosa will come the other way.
I like the defense on Cook. Get up in, force him to dribble, 1-2 dribbles. You're going to get him, but he's going to shoot a lower percentage.
Barbosa misfires again. He's now 1-for-5 from the field. Just over 2 minutes gone by here in the second. Odom, there's the help defense. Count it, and a foul.
Odom can get that anytime. He's so clever off the dribble with the left hand coming into the middle of the floor. Now, you never know when he's going to elevate. See, right there, the defender who came on the trap was late. You've got to come at that extra step. You cannot allow him to get in the painted area because he plays the backboard, Mike, as good as any forward that we have in the league.
Barbosa picks up his third foul. Odom with a chance for a three-point play. Lamar Odom, one of those players, this game is so versatile. Began his career with the Clippers, first 4 years with the Clippers, then had a terrific year in Miami with the Heat. However, traded here to Los Angeles in the Shaquille O'Neal deal. Last year, he had some injuries, had some adjustment problems in terms of the triangle. But this year, the second half of the season, really playing close to triple-double almost every night. And has been just superb here in this series. Nash for three. Steve Nash, 6-for-7 from the field. He's got 14 points.
Now, talk about leadership. This is what this guy's all about. When he's on fire, they're a handful. Now, right now, in spite of things, they're right there. They're sitting comfortably. The main thing right now is they've got to continue to score in this quarter.
Devin George able to put it in.
Now, they need Devin George, no doubt about it with the Lakers. Devin George has been very quiet in the series.
Had an injury-plagued regular season, getting some minutes with the foul trouble. James Jones can't hit.
Yeah, bad angle. He definitely did not have control of the basketball when he elevated.
Shooting numbers, 59% for the Lakers, 41
nice
for the Suns. Cook, 7 points for Cook in 5 minutes off the bench.
Mike, that's the second time that little cut from the opposite side has opened up into a layup.
And Rajah Bell able to hit.
All right, now Vucevic, he's all upset. He's saying, I got pushed. Look, you got to fight through the screens. This is the playoffs. You just don't get screened by a guy standing in an area. You've got to decide whether you're going over the top or whether you're getting through.
And a defensive 3 seconds. We'll have a timeout. So a technical foul and one shot coming up. Lakers, though, with all the foul problems with Kobe Bryant, Lamar Odom, they still have a one-point lead here early in the second. His teammates once again firing up Mr. Bryant.
The main thing is, though, that Kwame Brown and then Parker and Walton, between them, they're all averaging 14 points in the series.
Shot clock again, winding down. Brown, good quick move, but can't finish.
It's all right. The main thing is the move was quick, and he got a high percentage shot. That's going to be there. He's so big and wide that he can take whoever is playing him defensively to the glass.
Nash
look
again gets
look
inside.
This.
Steve Nash, so crafty.
That's his fourth layup, and he makes it look like he's in slow motion, a little bit like Larry Bird would do it, off the dribble, taking his time, reading the defense. Next thing you know, they're laying it up in your face.
And he loves that left hand. He's got 16 points here in this first half, and there's still 5.5 to go in the second. Shot clock once again winding down. The Suns playing good, hard defense as Parker has to flip up a wild shot. Suns doing a better job on the defensive
boards.
Yes,
course. They are, Mike. Yeah, you're absolutely right. They're forcing him into sometimes when they go one-on-one into low percentage shots.
Marion just 1-for-4. And the Lakers will walk it up.
Mike, you cannot forget about Lamar Odom, right? You just can't do that. If you're going to work in the triangle, fine. Either you use Kwame Brown or Lamar Odom.
Shot clock again, down to 3. Odom, tough move. James Jones comes away. Diaw.
Nice.
The extra pass. Diaw finds a way.
Nash took the 3 defenders, Mike. Now Nash could have forced up a bad percentage shot, but he'll exhaust you. He'll exhaust you with the dribble. All you have to do is just move without the ball and create a passing lane. He'll get you to your shot, and it'll be high percentage.
Suns playing with that spirit that perhaps was lacking last couple of games. Odom, there's a double team. Walton.
Nice.
Brown. The extra pass from Luke Walton.
That's right. See, now Odom can pass out of the double team. He found Walton, and Walton created the easy shot. That's the advantage of Luke Walton, being another guy who can create for you.
He's just a playmaker, according to Phil Jackson. And he's flourished with Jackson. Diaw.
Diaw can get that all day when he's matched up with Kwame Brown. Kwame Brown steps back from him, and because he does not want Diaw to take him off the dribble.
Brown again calling for it.
There it is.
Odom.
Oh, boy, air ball. And I tell you, you can get that any time, especially if the defender is going to go behind the screen.
Nash looking for Marion. Mismatch there with Vujicic on him. Instead, the 3. Tough shot with Odom guarding him.
Yeah, I was surprised. I thought he would go right inside that time to Marion.
Kwame Brown. Try to force it up. Diaw did a good job keeping his arms straight up. Crowd wanted a foul as Nash comes down and goes long.
But that's their game. Their game is transition. If we can hold you to one shot, get it out quick. If we can turn you over, get it out quick. We are shooting quick on the break.
And again, Odom, the double team deflected.
Nice.
With Parker right there.
Yeah, good deflection, but a good look.
And Odom draws the foul. The crowd, Kobe Bryant was saying the crowd the other night on Friday night reminded him of an NBA Finals crowd or a Game 7 crowd. There's something about the underdog role that inspires the fans. Parker, a quick 3. As they're trying to go for the 2-for-1, and Nash will walk it up. There's about a 4-second difference now between shot and game clock. Nash has been superb here in the first half, but doing more scoring than passing. Gets inside. Shot clock at 2. Nash falling away. And a 24-second violation.
Yeah, the pass out was not a good pass. Whenever that happens, you've got to be able to be in position to make the catch and shoot. Unfortunately, the catch was a difficult catch.
The guy with 3 fouls is coming back in the game for the final possession.
Glenn, you're playing defense right now. You have got to sacrifice your body and try to take a charge on Kobe Bryant.
Rajah Bell right with Bryant. Plenty of time for a quality shot. Bryant looking. Leans in. Blocked from behind by Jones. The second shot off the mark. And that will end the first half.
Phoenix, big time trouble. We know that Steve Nash has had a great first half with 16 points, 7 for 11. Diaw with 4 field goals. The rest of the team, 5 for 22. The rest of the team outside of Diaw and Nash are shooting 22%. Can't get it done, Mike.
Meanwhile, Parker picks up his third foul as we check in with Lisa.
Well, Mike, Kurt Rambis said at the half that the Lakers have to do a much better job of staying in the team's offense. He says guys get out of focus because of the way the Suns play deep. And he said hopefully that will change once Kobe Bryant, the team leader, is back in the game, because of foul trouble, he spent a lot of that half on the bench. He said when we have our team leader on the floor, hopefully Kobe will play better, and that means we will play better. Mike?
Meanwhile, for Phoenix, they hope Sean Marion plays better, and that's not a bad start for Marion.
Yeah, right. And now all the other scorers that average 13 or more, that everyone will step up.
Bryant was terrific when he was on the floor, but just again, 3 fouls as Parker in and out on the three-pointer. Bryant back on Rajah Bell. Nash again gets inside. Nash has had no problem whatsoever getting easy layups.
Now, Smish Parker cannot stop him from getting to where he wants to go. And then once he makes up his mind off that hesitation dribble, he's going all the way.
But Nash would be the first to tell you he'd prefer to pass the ball, get his teammates involved. He's had to look for a shot. It's been there. Parker, nice play, can't finish. And the Suns will come on the other way.
Mike, it's playoff time. You know, there's going to be plenty of physical contact. When things don't happen, you must make it happen yourself.
Rajah Bell with a hand right in his face, and a quick 6-0 run by the Suns.
Now, this is the guy that they need to step up. Rajah, we know, is playing. He's got a bad groin area, but they need him to get cooking right now. He's 2-for-4 from the field. Why? Because he's a 14, 15-point scorer for you.
Bryant was doubled. Kwame Brown didn't go after the pass. It's a turnover.
Yeah, Kwame Brown, bad mistake. You just can't look at a pass when all you had to do was take one step and grab the basketball.
Again, Bryant playing with 3 fouls, pokes it away. Still Suns ball with 11 on the shot clock. Rajah Bell, in his first year with Phoenix, Mike D'Antoni said one of the reasons that they acquired him is Steve Nash asked him to. He played together with him in Dallas, blocked by Odom. Perfect timing.
Yeah, Odom left his man on the other side of the floor, came across. Now, that Nash, remember now, has 5 layups in this game.
Again, the double team on Bryant. Can't get it to fall. Kwame Brown knocked away, but a foul. Rajah Bell on the reach-in. They're going to call it in the act of shooting as Bell picks up his second.
Now, both teams struggling at halftime, Mike, shooting the basketball. Phoenix only shooting 39, and then the Lakers only shooting 43. So there have been a ton of offensive rebound opportunities. Now, both teams, though, have done a terrific job on the defensive glass.
And you see Kwame Brown getting the minutes as he misses the first. Kwame Brown was the first overall pick back in 2001 by Washington, right out of high school. First time the first overall pick was a kid from high school to the NBA. And for 4 years with the Wizards, they said he wasn't living up to his promise. And early this year in L.A., in his first season with the Lakers, he was really struggling. Had heard boos here at the Staples Center. But when Chris Mim went down with an injury late in the season, he got an opportunity to play big minutes, and he has taken advantage.
Absolutely. Last 18 games of the year and in this playoff. He's good for 12 to 13 points a game.
Diaw can't hit.
See, with Kobe in the lineup now in this playoff, he's getting you 7 rebounds a game. You can see he wants to score. You can see that.
That's a travel.
Yeah, he's looking today, Mike, to get down, foul line down, take his man and get down in there and look for the score.
8th turnover by the Lakers. Only 3 for the Phoenix Suns. Vujicic in the game for Smush Parker now. They try the alley-oop. Nash again on the drive. Looking, finding Diaw. Diaw inside.
Oh, great shot. How about that for an acrobatic shot? That's the second one where he's down inside and you say, you know what? He's not going to get off the shot. And he'll somehow squirm, make a move with his body, and come up in there with a layup.
Largest lead by either team as the Suns take a 7-point advantage. Luke Walton comes right back the other way. Walton has gotten the extra minutes, and he's taken advantage in the series.
Well, when they go to him in the pivot on the triangle, good things happen. He scores down in there, or he finds someone with an assist.
Nash inside. Nash yelling for a foul. Yelling at Sean Carbon as he comes up the floor. Brown. Losing his height advantage.
See, he can get in the low post, Mike. There's a difference between medium, high post, and low. If he stays down inside, something good will happen.
We'll talk about a quick turnaround. Off the make, they can score so quickly.
If I'm playing Diaw, and I see Nash dribble in the lane or down the bench, I am not leaving Diaw, because Diaw creates a passing lane in the paint.
Vujicic again from downtown. He's been on fire from long range in his limited minutes. 8 of 10 in the series. And it's back to a 2-point game. James Jones, and that's his first 3-pointer of the series. And a big one as the Suns back up by 5.
And during the season, he had a terrific year. And off the bench or as a starter, he was very consistent.
Kwame Brown fouled. And he'll shoot two.
I like Kwame's movement. Anytime that you're in the post area, Kwame, if he's on the other side of the lane, I know it's within their offensive movement. Get across the lane, create the passing angle, and then go strong to the basket. The key is he must step up and shoot over 60%. Right, he's got to give up and make these shots.
Kwame Brown, last year the playoffs were a nightmare for him. He played with the Washington Wizards. They actually told him to stay home. He didn't show up for a shoot-around. He was having problems with one of his teammates, Gilbert Arenas. And he wound up finishing the season watching his team play in the playoffs at home. And everybody had started talking about the term underachiever for him. And it's nice to see the young man. It's not easy with the pressure. And part of it certainly is his fault in terms of he needed to work harder. He needed to learn to be a professional. But he's starting to grow, and it's nice to see the young man now starting to look like a pro.
Well, when young guys come in the league with talent, Mike, it always keeps coming down. You're a raw diamond in the rough. Now it's going to come down to your work habits and your maturity and then how you are going to fit into the chemistry. He could not find it in Washington, but he's doing an excellent job here.
Taking small steps to get himself on track. Jones steps back. That's a two-pointer. In and out. Marion the rebound.
Well, that was a tough catch again.
Here's Diaw. We're going to post up Vujicic. Jones will try it again. Marion, his 8th rebound. Marion starting the board like he did during the regular season. Nash. Diaw gets inside. Crazy pass. Marion won't go down.
They maximize that possession, Mike. They kept moving and moving and moving until they get the high percentage shot.
Tommy Brown, big height advantage, a quick spin move. And look at Diaw corral that rebound.
Now that's been there for the entire game. Good move by Tommy Brown.
Excellent defense, enough to distract Nash. And last touch by Nash, a rare turnover for the Phoenix Suns.
Now, Kwame was not happy with his offensive move. He threw the ball off the glass a little too hard, did not get the bank. But then he did not give up on the play.
But Kobe, the word got out, has asked to be number 24 next year. And that's because that was the number he wore earlier in his high school career at Lower Marion. And how about that? Years ago, he loves D'Antoni. He's now playing against him in the NBA playoffs.
main thing right here for the Lakers. You got to get back to scoring points in the paint. You dominated in the paint in games 1, 2, and 3. Today, Phoenix has outscored you in the painted area 32-22. That's a plus 10. You've got to get back to your strength and understand that you work inside out in the series.
That's been the key through the first 3 games as they've attacked the weaknesses of the Suns. Rajah Bell knocked that time and walked the rebound. But there's no question, UB, there's an extra bounce in the Suns' step that perhaps wasn't there in game 3.
Well, Mike, you can't say they're shooting better because they're not. Oh, you can't miss those. Oh, boy.
He did draw the foul.
Yeah, but, you know, still in all, Mike, when you're going strong with both hands, you can take a good hit. All right, and that was not even a good hit. Got to get the easy ones. In a game like this, you got to get either out on the break, and we're having no fast breaks today. There's only been one basket scored by either time on the break. Now, the key then is second shot attempts. Second shot attempts somewhat limited today because of good defensive rebounding. Well, then the key is in the half-court movement, every time you get a dunk, you've got to go strong because it's a potential three-point play.
And once again, for the second straight game, Kwame Chance at the Staples Center. Keep for Kwame Brown. He's still such a young man. He's only 24 years old, and this is his fifth year in the league. Nash.
Phoenix getting good looks, Mike. You got to be happy. First 7 minutes of this quarter, they're getting wide open looks.
Kobe Bryant creating his open look. He's got 10.
Well, you know, he had 8 in that first quarter, but then sitting out, only playing 9-plus minutes. Well, naturally, now he wants to get cooking here. He wants to get unraveled.
And a foul. Now they call a carry on Barbosa. Barbosa felt he got bumped.
Yeah, Barbosa's struggling today. We know he's 1-for-5 from the field. He just has not been able to get into the swing. Let's just see what happens now as he gets major minutes as we end this quarter into the fourth quarter.
Under 5 minutes remaining here in the third. It's been a tight game throughout. Bryant with 3 defenders around him. That time he finishes.
That's right. When Kobe gets that double team and they have a guard on you, go strong.
Kwame Brown once again having a solid game. 12 points, 8 rebounds. Nash inside. He got hit on the head.
They're going to argue this. They're catching it. That time, see, Bennett Salvatore pulled it on a pass off. Nash came running out of there that 8 hours shooting the ball.
They're going to say a 2-shot foul. Okay. Brown second. Bryant pleading his case with Sean Corbin.
Well, Kenny Maurer came in there and I think talked it over with Bennett Salvatore. Keep an eye right here. You're going to see that he thought he was probably looking, but then at the last second, you can see he was going to use reverse spin on the glass.
Oh, wow. The best free throw shooter in the NBA. This is one. A rare miss from the Suns. They haven't been to the line very often. In fact, Phoenix this year set an NBA record for fewest free throws made and attempted in a season. They were also number one in percentage, so when they got there, they took full advantage.
Well, Nash coming in is only 15 for 16. I mean, so he didn't. I mean, now he's missed 2, Mike. We have to tell him he's got to work on his game.
He's obviously not practicing as we have the foul away from the ball. It's going to go against Rajah Bell. That's his third.
Just watch as Kobe Bryant takes the double team. There's your double team right there. Look to the left. That's it. Create the passing lane. Anytime that your man leaves you a double team, it's your job to create the open passing lane.
He's led the team in assists in all 3 games in this series. He has 5 this afternoon. Lamar Odom. Brown blocked by Bell. Crowd wanted a foul.
Look up. Look up.
Barbosa. Reverse.
Nice.
Bryant made him alter the shot, and Barbosa with a pretty move.
Now, that was a great rundown by Kobe Bryant. The fact that he made that became a difficult shot.
Bell playing with 3 fouls, make it 4. And now they're in the penalty, so Kobe Bryant will shoot free throws.
Keep an eye right here. FS breaking now. Look to the left of your screen. See, Kobe was going for the block, but that was a difficult shot. Barbosa was behind the board on that release.
He also perhaps a step behind because he was talking with Bennett Salvatore as he came down the floor. And here comes the MVP chance. Of course, the story earlier this week from the Arizona Republic said that Steve Nash will win his second straight MVP, but it has not been officially announced by the NBA. That's a couple of weeks away. Both of them had just spectacular seasons.
Well, he has come out, meaning Kobe Bryant, in the second half. He is going to score. He's looking every single time that he touches the ball for a shot attempt.
Chance of defense. The Laker team that has played terrific defense here in the series. Thomas left-handed.
Pretty. I tell you, Tim Thomas is in this game with a banged-up knee that happened in Game 3. Now, remember, he has scored 17 points and has 10 rebounds a game.
Vujicic, a rare miss from three-point range for him. Nash again. Coast-to-coast Nash, but it falls off the rim.
He just told Kenny Maurer, that's the second time that I've gone to the basket and gotten fouled.
Walton, Odom calling for it against Marion. And a foul before the shot. And as Marion picks up the personal, he had a lot to prove this year. Bryant did not play in the playoffs last year. First time in his NBA career. And he's been a big part of the development of this team. The out to Thomas for three. Rolls around and drops out.
Yeah, but Mike, see, they're getting good looks at the basket. And that's a major plus. Once the Lakers hold them down to make them execute in the half court, with Diao and Nash, they're getting good looks.
Odom gets a good look. And the Lakers back up by three.
That's the guy they've got to go to. You've got to explore him because they can't handle him in a half-court game or in a transition game.
And the Lakers very upset as Smush Parker again called for the foul on the alley-oop attempt to Marion. That's four on Parker.
Mike, the refs all day today, anytime on this lob pass, if you're going to step under a guy, and that is definitely stepping under, they are calling it. And they have been very consistent since we started this ball game.
There's no question that was a foul. Again, the severity wasn't that harsh a foul, but that makes a big difference in what Marion's able to do.
That's right.
Eddie House to Diao. And a travel. No, they call a blocking foul, where it looked like Diao traveled before the contact. Bennett Salvatore is going to come and talk to Kenny Maurer. The officials with some communication here. Let's see if they change the call.
Well, we have a guy right close to us.
They do change it.
So,
there was exactly, I think 14,600 people had the travel. Four had the foul.
Yeah, but I like you. You had it on the initial move. All right, come on. I like that.
They wouldn't give me a whistle before the game.
Well, you know, Kenny Maurer had, he thought he had a push in the back and that caused it. But then again, Bennett Salvatore just stepped right in and they got the call correct.
And that's the bottom line. Good communication from the officials. Kobe Bryant to Vujicic.
Plenty of time.
There you go.
And a three-second violation called on Lamar Odom, who's saying, hey, I was open.
Yeah, well, Vujicic went to the other side of the floor, Mike, and he had Odom down inside. Odom is telling him right now, you know, look to me, I was on the same side of the floor.
Minute and a half remaining here in this third quarter. Marion finally gets a perimeter shot to go, just his third field goal. He's done other things here this afternoon, but they could use his scoring.
Well, this is a big matchup in the series, Odom and Marion. Odom having probably a little bit the better of it right now, only because Marion is struggling with his shot.
Barbosa staying with Bryant, and a foul before the shot. They're in the penalty, so Bryant will go to the line.
Now, Kobe Bryant, no way can Barbosa play behind him in that situation. Kobe Bryant will just back him down, and he'll pin him, and he'll call for the ball. Now, just watch. Once he gets that call, no way can Barbosa play. Now, you need the double team. It's got to come faster than that.
The MVP chance once again for Kobe Bryant. misses a free throw tonight on TNT. It's the Wizards hosting the Cavs game four, followed by Sacramento hosting San Antonio. 7 Eastern coverage beginning. And then Monday on NBA TV, Detroit and Milwaukee, game four of that series. Boy, misses two.
Well, you don't see that often. He's an 85% foul shooter. During the season, he gets to the line 10-plus times. Now, in this series, he's only been there 7 times. They've done a good job.
Marion Rushton gets a second opportunity. Yeah. And that's the way Sean Marion scores.
That's right. Well, you know, he's not just a great one-time jumper. He's a two-jumper. He's up, down, and he's right back in your face again.
And he has his first double-double of the series. He's amongst the leaders during the regular season in that. Bryant, double team, gets away. Tough shot.
Well, he's not going to allow the little guys to play him down there. And when you have House in there and Barbosa, if you're on Kobe Bryant, he's going to take advantage.
Smith Parker with the steal, but Vujicic couldn't hold on. And the Suns get it back with 28 seconds remaining. The crowd's been up applauding the effort of these L.A. Lakers. Again, the 7th seed. And since the NBA went to the 16-team playoff format, only 4 7th seeds have defeated the 2nd seed. They're 4-40 during that time.
Go right back, that's right. We have plenty of time here.
Barbosa. That's a two-pointer. Marion comes flying in, and he gets fouled.
Marion split the two defenders. He split Odom and Kobe Bryant, flew right in there. Now just keep an eye on the shot. Now look to the left of your screen. All right, you can see Marion went right in between the two of them, and he was sandwiched. Now Sean Corbin was right on top of that play.
And that's 4 fouls on Kobe Bryant. Sean Marion starting to play. The Suns, again, not getting to the line often, but converting. They're 9 of 10.
It's a second effort, and that's what Steve Nash talked about in the video at the beginning of the first quarter. So come with an attitude. We got to have an attitude. Uh-oh, look out.
Barbosa with the steal. Ball deflected by the Lakers.
You can't fall asleep here. You know, after those foul shots, Mike, there are 6 seconds left here. Now, you got to be careful. 3.3. You know, you got plenty of time, Phoenix. Just do not rush your shot.
The Lakers do not have a foul to give. Luke Walton's going to come in for defensive purposes here on the final possession. Kwame Brown will sit. .3 remaining.
Yeah, they need a guy to stay with Thomas Fuller. Oh, how about that?
Goaltend.
Good ball.
Boy, terrific set play. Lakers falling asleep here in the last couple of seconds of the period.
No doubt about it, Mike. And that's the one thing you never want to do. You never want to have to defend the lob pass in the paint.
Now 1.9. That's plenty of time for the Lakers to get off a shot. Odom. It'll count if it goes. Oh, just off the side. And that will end the third period. Sean Marion coming alive for the Phoenix Suns. He had 10 points in the third period alone. And now with his first double-double of the series. Good play to Florida International. Wasn't drafted back in 99. Played in the CBA, the USBL, the IBL. Took him 2 years to get to the NBA. Played for 4 teams in 6 years. This is his first year in Phoenix, and he's had his best season playing with Steve Nash again. The two of them played in Dallas together.
Good hands.
Barbosa brings him back out.
In this series, Phoenix averaging 9 three-point makes a game. Today, 3 for 11.
They set an NBA record with most threes in a regular season. And a foul call. Sasha Vujicic with a hold.
Well, see, Sasha is not, he's not ready for all this physical contact. When you guard House, House is moving. He's going to come off of 1 screen, 2 screens down on the baseline. And then he's going to pop you to get free with his forearm.
ball, so they'll reset the shot clock to 14. Eddie House, coming off the bench, has had some big fourth quarters for this team, but has not received a lot of minutes here in this series. Thomas,
nice move.
Gets inside, board. Plenty of contact there. Two on the shot clock. DL has to put it up, just gets it off in time. And Chip Thomas knocked out of bounds. Suns ball.
Now that was good hustle. Now, good defense, solid defense by the Lakers, taking all of those screens and matching up perfectly. And then the Suns, not forcing a shot, they get the good look, and then once again, they hustle you for the loose ball.
Let's send it over to Lisa.
Well, Mike, Tim Thomas probably should not be even playing in this game. As you remember, he tweaked his left knee on Friday, in Friday's game three. I asked him before the game, how is it? He said, actually, I'm hurt, but I'm trying not to think about it. I said, how can you not think about it? He says, you know what? I just don't have time. It's the playoffs. I've got to play. Mike.
And he's doing more than scoring. He's rebounding. He's defending. Things he's not known for, but he's played every part of the game.
No, you're absolutely right, Mike. And he's everywhere. And this group right now, they're getting deflections and steals. And the Lakers have got to regroup, Mike.
And they're scoring in a hurry, forcing the turnovers, and Phil Jackson wants a timeout as the Suns exploding there with Sean Marion again finding his game.
Mike, from now to the end of this game, we have 10 and a half minutes. The Lakers must improve in two categories. They already have 14 turnovers, and they've already missed 7 foul shots. These two areas, you've got to pick it up.
Kobe Bryant, foul trouble in the first half. There's the double on Odom.
He'll find a three-man every time.
Devin George, there's a three-man.
We need George also to come off the bench. So he's been non-existent in this playoff. Championship years, he was able to be a good starter or a good backup at small forward and hit that three at a high percentage for you.
Eddie House rushed it. And Thomas tips it, but right to Vujicic. Three on two break for the Lakers. George, another three. Puts it in. Timeout Phoenix. Meanwhile, so important this game four, the teams that take that 3-1 lead. Doesn't happen often where the team down is able to come back. Well, the Suns want to even things up.
Major thing has been bench production right now. Lakers 24-12 in bench production. Cook, Vujicic, and then George. Good contribution.
To Thomas, shot clock winding down. Nash falling away. Ball, Thomas right there. And again, Tim Thomas with a big rebound.
Yeah, he's come in and he's giving him the size factor, and that's really helped out. That's his fifth rebound, Mike. Now, he hasn't played a lot of minutes. He's only played 17 minutes, but he's making his presence felt.
They need his size without, as you saw, in the street clothes, Amari Stoudemire and Kurt Thomas. Brian Cook. Cook for three. And DL tracks it down. Thomas took his eye off it, looking to shoot before he caught it. Yeah. Devin George for three. Won't go. Cook keeps it alive.
Good hustle. Good hustle that time. That was an excellent pass by Bryant to the other side. And good diagonal look.
Bryant. Cook. He's been firing away. Odom tips it back out of bounds. Last touch by the Lakers.
Now that's why you run it, Cook. You run it, Cook, so that he cannot catch and shoot. He's so dangerous, shoots a high percentage. Force him to put it down. He put it down on the floor, and he got himself in a bad angle, and he could not play the board.
Luke Walton and Kwame Brown set to check back in. Suns by three still. So much time remaining here in the fourth. Suns again shooting 43%. That's been the number in each of the last two games. But they're playing a little bit more grit here this afternoon.
What time?
Jones. Bell. Diaw. Roy short. Bryant. Another rebound. His 11th of the game. He's having a typical Sean Marion game there.
Yes, he is. And what they're doing is they're winning the hustle points. Not only with the little intangibles on loose balls, but they're winning the hustle points and points in the paint.
Diao gets inside.
They just love it. See, that's what they like to do off the dribble. They break you down. They force you to play them for the full 24 seconds. If you relax, Diao and Nash can get to the rim.
Kobe Bryant again looking to pass quite a bit. This time knocked away by Marion and a steal.
Yep.
And then they say a kick ball by the Suns, so it's Laker ball.
That was a terrific double team. It came quick. Kobe could not come back and see it with the peripheral vision. That was just a beautiful watch. It's good hands by Sean Marion. And they're calling that a kick. You know, it's the old story of, was that a deliberate kick or an accidental kick?
It's that was tough to see. Now, of course, Nash was a big-time soccer guy. He still plays soccer a lot in the summer.
That's right. Well, you probably go to his games in New York, right?
Yeah, it's very difficult to get a ticket. So yeah.
He said he only plays on two teams.
Shot clock down to 7. Bryant again finds a teammate. Odom methodically gets inside. Foul. And Kobe Bryant not forcing it, and his teammates able to shine because of the unselfish play.
Odom very quietly has his 16 points. Think about him today. Every time that he's gone to the basket, whether it's from the top or whether it's on the baseline move, something good happens.
And the numbers for Odom during the regular season led the team in rebounding and assists. An average 14 a game, shot 48%. Back to a two-point game. Came in and did a good job making sure he couldn't hit the shot.
Now, they will run the screen and roll from the wing. They'll run it time and time again. And if that player rotates to that baseline like Diao just did, you have got to come faster than that on the rotation.
Boris Diao, who was born in Paris. His mom was a great center. They say the best center in the history of the France national team. Knocks down the first one. And when he was drafted with Atlanta, they tried to play him as a point guard. That wasn't his spot. And he was acquired here in Phoenix. And Phoenix always liked his game. They played him up front in the front court. And he's used his quickness and he's had a magnificent season. One of the most likable guys you'll find in the NBA.
And very humble. And the fact he's a total team player. And it showed with his statistics for the season. His creativity, the fact that he can make the play, and then go, offensive foul.
On Kobe Bryant. Yeah, that's going to be his fifth.
See, that's Rajah Bell annoying you, getting up in there with the physical contact. Now, here it is right here. We tell you, there's a lot of respect here. You can see the push-off. He definitely pushed the ball with his left hand.
So, 5 fouls on Kobe Bryant. With 6.5 to play, Nash. Diao gets inside. Bell. James Jones, that's a two. Big shot from Jones as the shot clock winds down.
Mike, he was going away from the basket. And he was able to make that last dribble a hard dribble so that he could get up.
A surprise starter, James Jones, because of the injury to Tim Thomas. He's got 8 points.
Right now, Diao is trying to deny the pass to Bryant, but he'll run it down.
Again, there's the double team. Bryant leans in and goes short. Just past the midway point near the fourth. That's a rare fourth shot for Kobe Bryant over the shot clock was winding down. Marion off the dribble. Sean Marion with his best game of the series, 20 points and 11 rebounds, and this is the largest lead of the game. Seeing a double team every time he puts it on the floor. This time takes it to the glass, block, but a foul. And Sean Marion very upset. He thought it was clean. But Bryant will shoot two.
We're seeing excellent energy at both ends of the floor. Now, this is the best today of the Phoenix defense, time and time again. Kobe today is now looking to split. All right, looking to split that trap. That was a strong move. Now, you could see he thought that well, that was a block. All right, but then he was hit down below, underneath. So the referees were right there in good position.
And he got hit several times.
Yes, he basket.
Right. Marion, meanwhile, picks up his fourth foul. And you see Kobe Bryant hasn't even reached the 30-point mark in this series, but it's been successful for the Lakers. Will he have to, though, take over down the stretch of this game?
Big thing is keeping Kobe off the foul line. That's been excellent throughout the series. Seven times or less. Whoops.
Nash, Marion. Passing up open threes. Nash in and out. But Dial with an offensive rebound. Nash again for three. Won't go.
Two great looks. On the first one that he passed up, he just did not have his balance.
Under five to play. Swish Parker, the runner. Parker gets his own rebound.
Yeah, just set up. Set up, stay within. Work the offense.
Bryant against Marion. Again, seeing the two defenders. Odom to Parker.
Oh!
Tommy Brown on the follow.
Oh,
misses
no, it. No, not a one-hander. You go up strong in that situation.
Point-blank range. Jones for three. And over the rebound.
Now they catch a break right there. That would have been death if they hit that three.
Suns just 3-14 from downtown.
Tommy Brown cannot get tired now. You've got to be quick on your movements and then be looking, be positive.
Oh, good power move and a foul.
Sean Marion is upset. He thought that Odom jumped into his chest. He just saw the mic being D'Antoni on the other side. He's in Kenny Maury here. Now just watch this now as he goes down. As he steps back, you're saying, hey, I'm holding my ground. But the offensive player gets that call 9 out of 10 times.
And Marion gets his fifth foul. And Tony pleading his case. So Odom with a chance to complete the three-point play. Another strong game for Odom.
Well, you just can't play it any better than that. Marion was right there, took away the lane. But how about the fact, once again, Odom plays the board. He plays it beautifully on his bench shots.
And it's back to a three-point game with 4 minutes remaining. Suns want to go home with this series tie. Dial.
Nice.
Hold on, Parker. Basket will not count. Lakers not in the penalty, so the Suns will take it out of bounds as Parker picks up his fifth.
Mike, I was surprised on the initial move. When Nash came off of that, there was a switch. Dial had Parker on him. He hesitated, and Nash waited for him to go down into the posted area. And then once he had that, come on, you could either shoot up over the top of Parker, but take him strong to the rim. That was a beautiful move.
So Parker, who's had a rough game after leading the team in scoring in the last game, 0-for-9 from the field. And Park actually stays in with his five fouls.
You got to take him. You got to take him off the dribble.
Marion stripped by Parker. Dial. Shot clock winding down. Nash for three. Batted around. Marion tried to save it. Laker ball.
Now the Lakers are catching some breaks here. Nash has had three great looks at the rim. We're talking about a guy who every year shoots over 40% in threes. And he's had a great game today.
3.5 remaining. Lakers the underdog coming into the series with the 7th seed. Trying to take that 3-1 lead.
A lot of pressure on the defense right now, Phoenix. Yeah, see, Kobe wants to isolate on the side over on the right-hand side. Roger Bell fights him now. He did not want to let him go for the lob.
The double team, Walton back. Won't go. And Sean Marion, an open rebound, his 12th. The Suns clinging to a three-point lead.
Yeah, but they're getting good looks, Mike. As long as they stay within what they're doing, they'll get something good.
Dial again wants to post up Parker.
Well, why not?
Pass, throw it past Marion. Does Dial need to take advantage there and get a basket?
Yeah, well, you see, only because it ended up in a turnover. The idea was great, because as soon as he felt the double team coming, he was looking for the guy on the baseline. Unfortunately, a bad pass, but the idea was perfect, because you would have had a layup.
It's only their ninth turnover, but it comes at a bad time with just over 2.5 to play. Odom, strip, and a foul. And Sean Marion is just fouled out of the game.
Major loss here. Major loss here, because you need an athletic guy to match up with Odom as we go down the stretch in the last 2 minutes and 37 seconds.
Marion having his best game of this series with 20 points and 12 rebounds, but his sixth foul will send him to the bench. And of course, the Suns already shorthanded up front with the injuries.
Well, at the beginning of the quarter, we said that the Lakers had already missed 7 foul shots, and that pressure was on them, one, not to turn it over, and then two, to make the foul shots as we go down the lane.
Now, Marion thinks he only has 5 fouls. Normally, a player is aware. As Marion feels, he's saying, wait a minute, I only have 5. So he's fouled out with 2:37 remaining.
Well, it's a good matchup now. Tim Thomas with the size will come in. It'll be interesting to see who will match up now with Odom.
And Odom will shoot 2. This is game 4 of this opening round best-of-7 playoff series. The Suns took game 1 at home, but then lost the home court by losing game 2. Lakers with an impressive win Friday night to take a 2-1 lead. And this one has been close throughout. Largest lead by either team is 8 as Odom makes it a 2-point game.
Mike, right now, Phoenix has gone small, okay? The Lakers now make a major substitution. They bring in George and they take out Kwame Brown so that they can match up.
Two clutch free throws for Odom. 1-point game.
Right now, every guy on the floor for Phoenix is a 3-point threat.
A 7-0 run by the Lakers. Nash kicks it out. Rajah Bell for 3. Puts it in. Big shot for Rajah Bell. And the Suns back up by 4.
Excellent offensive strategy by Mike D'Antoni. And then also Phil Jackson matching it quickness for quickness. But they had to go for the trap. And that opens you up.
Odom wants the ball. Here's the double team. Inside to Parker. Parker puts it in.
Great basketball. Great basketball. Unselfish play by Odom. Takes the trap. Finds the next man. And then the ability to look for the putter.
Under 2 minutes remaining. Dia drives inside.
They can do that all day. They just don't have anyone matched up with him who can stop Dia off the dribble.
Dia with his best game of the series. He's got 18. Rajah Bell, again, right up on Kobe Bryant.
Yeah, he got popped. He definitely did. He got popped with the elbow.
Odom, offensive foul. James Jones steps in and draws the charge.
Excellent defense. Beautiful rotation. Get there. Sandwich the offensive man. Take the charge whenever you can. See right here. See, here it comes. There it is. And he was definitely outside of the defensive circle.
Odom with his 4th foul. Has missed his last 8 shots from the field, but his teammates starting to hit now. Nash on the pull-up, tough shot, in and out. He's had about 4 of those.
Well, that's the first time now in a long time that they did not switch. They went under that, forced Nash to make the shot.
Odom on the drive.
Good pass.
Devin George for 3! Devin George from downtown!
That's taking the trap and making the pass without forcing a bad shot.
George had 7 points in the first 3 games combined. He's got 11 here in this one. Tim Thomas knocks it down.
Baby.
Thomas comes right back. The lead back up to 4.
How about that? Mike, come on. He caught that pass. He was bent over. And he had the ability and the strength to just go right up and shoot that 3 without a bounce.
And the Suns, teammates of Nash, now starting to hit the shots.
Suns, they have two fulls and 120. Odom guarded by DL. Lakers trying to take a 3-1 lead. They did some big shots here. Good defense, solid defense. Bryant for three. Nope. And Tim Thomas with another big play.
Well, you're in a situation right now. Now, come on, you're down 40.
To foul.
That's right. You just can't.
Because they have a foul to give.
That's right. They had a foul to give. Now, all right, now you got another full 20 for a second. Now, once again, you're up 40. You only got 16-8. Phoenix, you know you're going to get fouled. You know it's going to happen. Now it's going to come down to the Lakers go for the steal. You do not get the steal. You got to go for the quick foul. Put them on the line, and then remember, you only have one 20-second timeout, Lakers.
Trying to hold Nash away and get into Nash's hands. And now they need to foul. They have too much time to off and finally foul Diaw. So Diaw will shoot two free throws with 12.6 remaining.
Well, you can see they did not want to put Nash on the line. Now, unfortunately, though, if you take that stance, seconds, precious seconds, are going off the clock. Now, this puts pressure on Diaw to step up and make the shots.
Diaw 73% from the line during the regular season. This is his first playoff series. He's played tight early in the series, but had his best game here this afternoon. And two big free throws right now. It's only the second miss from the line all game for the Suns. They're 12 of 14. And again, the key thing to remember, the Lakers still have the one timeout remaining. It's a 20. Diaw makes it a 5-point game, and Phil Jackson will use his final timeout right now. All right, what's the strategy for the Lakers, Hubie?
Now, right now, the thing is you need the quickest score that you can get, whether it's a two or a wide-open three. If you take and force a three, what happens is if you make it, great. But if you miss it, then you foul, and the game will go from 5 to 6 and into 7. So the key thing right now is take it to the basket, go strong. It becomes down to clock management right now. Go strong to the rim. Hopefully you'll get the quick score, and then once again you got to go for the steal. But remember, Phoenix is sitting with two timeouts and a 20.
Reminder, tonight, a couple of terrific games on TNT. Games 4 between Cleveland and Washington, followed by San Antonio and Sacramento. And Monday on NBA TV, another game 4, Detroit and Milwaukee from Milwaukee. So 12.6 seconds remaining. Kobe Bryant, you got the feeling, Yubi, that he was looking to score more here in the fourth quarter, but the Suns did an excellent job getting the ball out of his hands.
They did a terrific job, Mike, enforcing turnovers today. Coming in here, the Lakers have only turned it over 12 times. They had already turned it over 14 at the end of three. They need a quick score here right now or a wide open three.
Smush Parker puts up the three.
That's it. With the smart move, you do not try to force a pass. If you cannot make the pass, call a timeout so that you move the ball to the other side of half court.
Parker, who was 1 for 10 from the field before that shot, knocks it down. And the Lakers are still alive. So Smush Parker makes it a 2-point game with 7.9 remaining. Again, a key is the Lakers are out of timeouts now. The Suns still have a timeout remaining, so if they have any problems getting the ball in bounds, they can still call time.
Well, we're sitting here with 7.9 seconds. The big key right now is do not allow a player to go long, or once they move the ball out to the 28-foot marker at the offensive end of the floor for Phoenix, the thing is you've got to go for the steal. If you get the steal, great. If you do not get it, you're going to have to foul. And when you foul, you can't be worrying about who's fouling. The big thing right now is clock management.
You know, you'd be so often in this case, teams immediately go for the foul instead of trying for that initial steal on the first pass or maybe the first dribble.
Yeah, you always want to put a good guy on the ball, a guy with a wingspan, so that it makes the pass difficult. Now, we know this year you can throw the ball into the backcourt and take the pressure off. It isn't like the early years of this league where the pressure was on the guy out of bounds. Now you know you can release it by throwing the ball into the backcourt. Big thing right now is do not force a pass. You are sitting here with timeouts.
So you have timeouts available if you are the Suns.
They still have a full and a 20. Meanwhile, the Suns during the regular season, the best free throw shooting team in the league at 81%. And they've even topped that here in the playoffs. They're 91% from the line coming into this game in this series. Tim Thomas, Rajah Bell, Steve Nash, James Jones, and Boris Diaw out there for the Phoenix Suns. Again, the Lakers out of timeouts.
They got to be matched up here now. Now, the clock. You cannot allow precious 7 seconds to go off the clock by not being close to a man.
They'd love to get it into Nash's hands, and they do. Well, knocked away, stolen by Parker.
Oh, there it is.
Here comes George to Kobe Bryant. Bryant inside. It's good. It's good. Tie game. 7 tenths of a second remaining. Of a second remaining, the Phoenix Suns with the timeout can advance the ball to the front court. That's plenty of time to get off the shot.
Absolutely. Plenty of time, Mike, to make a catch, turn, and shoot. The big thing right here is, once again, do not force the ball. You are sitting with a full timeout and a 20. That's what you had on that last possession. When in doubt, always use the timeout.
Let's listen to this play. We'll send the crowd absolutely crazy. What a comeback for the Lakers, down by as many as 8 points here in the fourth quarter. They've tied it up. And Phoenix will look to win it, or we'll see it overtime.
You can look at that and say, Diaw got the ball to our best guy, Steve Nash. But he got it to him in traffic, going away, close to the half-court line. Parker was able to reach back and get a piece of that ball to get a big-time deflection.
So plenty of time to catch and shoot. You can't put it on the floor, but you can catch and shoot on 7 tenths.
Yeah, you got to switch on all screens. You cannot give anybody an open look.
He out, and they use their final timeout. This time, Kobe Bryant wanted a 5 second count. It was close. And Phoenix will back in the huddle, and they'll try it again.
Every coach in the history of basketball in this situation called it a 5 second count.
You know that.
And the Suns, you'd be very fortunate to have that extra timeout. Once again, you look. The good ball denial from the LA
now
Lakers.
Watch Odom. See, Odom switches out right there at the top. They switched on their screen on the left side of the floor. They did a terrific job by jamming the passer. See, that's his one time. When you jam that passer, he has very little room to move back on the sideline in the NBA. Consequently, you are cutting down his avenues of a pass. Now, naturally, you cannot and you do not want to throw it to a guy who has gone by the three-point line, because it would be a miraculous catch, turn, and shoot. So you want to try to get it somewhere even with you or up front.
You have 5 seconds to get it in. But the Suns are out of timeouts. Diaw with Lamar Odom with his long arms trying to distract. Diaw lobs it into Jones. Jones, no! There was contact there. Jones thought he was fouled, but we will go to overtime. Parker, not drafted out of Fordham back in 2002. He bounced around the NBDL and in Greece. This is his first year with the Lakers. He started every single game. And two huge plays to keep the Lakers' hopes alive here this afternoon. Remember, Sean Marion has fouled out for the Phoenix Suns. Did so at the end of regulation. They'll certainly miss him here in the OT. Kwame Brown. And also remember, Kobe Bryant has five fouls.
Right, Tim Thomas did an excellent job. He bodied Brown up and kept him out from not allowing him to back him down in the paint.
Thomas has had another strong game playing with the bad knee. James Jones for three. Offensive foul. They call Diaw for knocking down Parker.
Yeah, that was a good call.
That's five on Diaw.
Well, just keep an eye right here to the bottom part. You're going to see right there. See, Diaw was moving. He was moving and he brought his body into him and then caught him with the elbow up high.
Well, this place, just bedlam with this comeback down eight in the fourth quarter.
Well, they are not going to allow Kobe unless he takes a three. They're all over him.
And a three-second violation call on Kwame Brown camping out in the paint.
Now, Rajah Bell is up in there, Kobe. He's not giving him any kind of a good look on a catch. And then as soon as he does catch the ball, Jones that time was on him like a cat. They're going to force him to try to give the ball up.
Nash has played 40 minutes. Gets inside. Tim Thomas, another three. Knocks it down. Tim Thomas, another big shot.
He's two for three in threes. But how about the fact, throughout this entire series, he's been absolutely a monster behind the three-point line.
Just critical. And again, playing with that sprained knee. Bryant. Gets inside. Hall blocked, but a foul. Thomas picks up the personal, and Kobe Bryant.
Now they're fronting the Walton in the post area. And if they front Walton in the post area, Kobe is looking to go in there, but then he's going to take you off the dribble. See, right here, he's going to force the trap. They were late there, and now he's going strong. That's what you love about his game. When he attacks the rim, he's going with two hands.
Leads the team in assists for the fourth straight game in the series with eight assists. Devin George, who provided a huge spark. George with 11 points off the bench, replaces Kwame Brown.
Well, they're trying to match up here. That's a defensive move, like offense, defense. They are going to make sure that they can cover the three-point shooters of the Suns.
See Bryant's numbers. Once again, the story. Kobe Bryant, not the one-man show. His teammates have helped pick it up. 1 point lead for Phoenix, trying to even the series at two games apiece.
Well, they've been wearing out the left side of this floor here, Mike.
Nash.
Hey, you got to go in the post, Timmy. You got the mismatch. There it is.
Marker on Tim Thomas. Tough shot for Thomas. Can't get it to fall. Luke Walton the rebound. Calls out a play. There's a play. Give it to Kobe.
They have a clear out here.
Bryant looks at the shot clock. Here comes the double team. Odom for three. And Rajah Bell the rebound.
I like the defense. Phoenix, they're talking. They're moving. Everyone is helping out.
Odom's played 46 minutes.
Well, there's the switch. They switch every time. Got plenty of time.
Again, they go to Thomas. Shot clock winding down. Posting up Parker. Thomas can't get it to fall.
Now, that was an easy move for him. And as soon as he made that baseline spin, you knew that when he went up. Uncontested shot.
Crowd getting on its feet once again. Shot clock down to eight.
And now you got to make a move here.
Parker puts it up. And Diaw the rebound. Not a good possession that time for the Lakers.
Now that's two in a row. Two in a row where they ended up with the clock down, ending up in a three-point attempt.
Diaw wants it. This time it's Diaw posting up high. Quick move inside. And the Suns back up by three. The Lakers coming out. When you play the overtime, each team gets three timeouts for the overtime. You shoot the penalty on the fourth team foul, but you also lose one timeout when you get under 2 minutes remaining in the extra period, and you still have the three. So the way it is now, in terms of timeouts, Suns have two, the Lakers have one. And both teams with a foul to give. Lamar Odom, the leading scorer for the Lakers.
Yeah, they're looking two-man basketball. Clear out on the side for Odom.
Odom can't get it. Second one won't go. Tip. Devin George comes down with it. And a new 24.
Good move by Kobe. Balance the floor. They have Walton in the post.
Walton wants it against Diaw, who has five fouls. Nice give and go. Odom foul.
Yes.
Count it. And a chance for a three-point play.
Now, that was a great pass. Now, when Odom cut, they catch Tim Thomas looking at the ball. Now, keep an eye on this now. Once his pass goes in, see Thomas left, he took his head off, and then Odom just stepped right out. Beautiful pass. A lot of players, you throw it in the post, they call that the black hole because it's going up. And that was just a beautiful drop off, and then Odom finishes and he gets to the line.
You see Odom, 13 free throw attempts. He'd been really struggling from the line prior to this afternoon, but another terrific performance. Meanwhile, Walton playing very well again. Chance to tie it here.
95-95.
This crowd's been on its feet much of the overtime. Nash with Odom on him. Ball deflected out of bounds or a foul? Still Suns ball. Deflected. Nash wanted the foul.
Soon as Nash saw that Odom was playing him, he was taking him one-on-one.
And Mike D'Antoni will use one of his two timeouts. With 10 seconds left on the shot clock, Phoenix will inbound with the game tied.
Good move by D'Antoni. Right now, you got plenty of time on the shot clock. You know that your timeouts were in your favor. Main thing now is when you come out of this huddle. Yeah, it's so difficult at the end of an NBA game. You've got to get maximum execution here, and you've got to get a good look at the basket.
You know, Smush Parker, who made the big plays at the end of regulation, the three-pointer and the steal of Nash in his first playoff series. Players like Boris Diaw and Smush Parker playing for the first time in the postseason in a game like this. Boy, the butterflies have to be there, Yudi.
You know the pressure. The pressure is terrific. But then when you get down to the last 3 minutes of a game like this, right, then the pressure magnifies itself. Then when you go into overtime, it's almost overbearing because you've been out on the floor with this type of intensity for a long period of time. It's mentally exhausting.
Again, the Lakers with a 2-1 lead in the series. They win here. They'll go back to Phoenix. And game five is Tuesday. They'd go back with a 3-1 lead. That's Tuesday in Phoenix. Then the return on Thursday here at the Staples Center, if necessary. And then, of course, a game seven possibility would be in Phoenix on Saturday.
Now, the Lakers are staying small to match up with Phoenix. Big thing now that you have to protect against, if you're the Lakers, dribble penetration by Phoenix and the kick out and the wide open three-point attempt.
10 seconds on the shot clock. 1:01 remaining in overtime. Vujicic right up on Nash. Nash looking, shot clock winding down, and a foul on Vujicic. They had a foul to give, so the Suns will inbound and get a new 24.
Now, that was a good switch, an excellent switch. George went right up on Nash, and you just love the posting up. The post up had Vujicic right on his back.
Well, off the foul, a shot clock reset, to 14. Nash, a three. Steve Nash from downtown, and the Suns back up by three.
And he's been struggling in the fourth quarter in the overtime. The shot has not been there for him, but
He's not afraid to take it, that's for sure.
Hey, man. He's looking. He was looking for that as soon as he came off the screen.
Kobe Bryant, Walton. Walton on the drive to Odom. Nice. Odom inside. Can't get it to fall.
Great pass. Beautiful pass. Excellent opportunity.
They don't have to foul here yet, though, Rudy.
No. There's about plenty of time.
11-second difference in a three-point game. Diaw kicks it out. Ball on the drive. Flips it up. Won't go. Ball deflected out of bounds. Laker ball. With 15.7 remaining.
Yeah, Rajah Bell, that was a good move off the dribble. Excellent idea. Got a good look at the basket. Unfortunately, the shot did not even catch the rim.
All right, now we have some real strategy here, UB. A three-point game. Do the Lakers try and go for the three right away? Do they go for the two? We'll discuss it when we come back. As Steve Nash has given the Suns the three-point lead.
Do you go for the quick score and then put the pressure on, go for the steal and foul? Or do you now say, I'm going to take a three? If we miss it, remember, a long rebound, kick it right back out again.
Lakers are out of timeouts. He's going for the two. Inside, quick score. So still plenty of time, a one-point game. Nash coming up. They have to foul. Nash looking. Tied up. Reach in. Oh, a jump ball! Nash is furious!
Nash said he would call in timeout. He thought that, but because of the trap, depending upon where the referee is stationed, could he hear Nash calling for the timeout? And you could see Nash was really upset.
There was also plenty of contact as they double-teamed Nash. I think he thought he was hit as well. Walton certainly with the height advantage here on this tip.
Remember,
6.1 remaining.
The Lakers, no timeouts here now.
A one-point game. Walton can tip it. Bryant with the save.
Now you got to get a shot here.
Final seconds. Bryant for the win. Bang!